him, we offer our petitions, and today especially to remember Father Robert Victoria for his eternal repose, and we hope that he is already in the presence of God. So in the petition, those who are in the bus also, we include them, of course, every day. We are all together, and our intentions is always for everyone in our family, the one who are left behind in our homes, they are always included in our petitions. And also, we thank God for Gerald for guiding us, and God will always bless him in this service for the people who goes to different sacred places. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Coming together as God's family with confidence, let us ask the Father's forgiveness for his full of gentleness and compassion.
A reading from the book of Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, thus should one regard us as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Now it is, of course, required of stewards that they may be found trustworthy. It does not concern me in the least that I be judged by you or any human tribunal. I do not even pass judgment on myself. I am not conscious of anything against me, but I do not thereby stand acquitted. The one who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, do not make any judgment before the appointed time until the Lord comes, for he will bring to light what is hidden in darkness and will manifest the motives of our hearts, and then everyone will receive praise from God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial song. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Trust in the Lord and do good, that you may dwell in the land and be fed in security. Take delight in the Lord, and he will grant you in your heart's request. requests.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Commit to the Lord your way. Trust in him, and he will act. He will make justice dawn for you like the light. Bright as the noonday shall be your vindication.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Turn from evil and do good, that you may abide forever. For the Lord loves what is right, and forsakes not his faithful ones. Criminals are destroyed, and the posterity of the wicked is cut off.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just is from the Lord. He is their refuge in time of distress, and the Lord helps them and delivers them. He delivers them from the wicked and saves them, because they take refuge in him.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Father, our Heavenly Father, he is so loving that you will not only see the bad things in your life, you will also see the good things. Probably you are jealous, you are hatred, you are anger, but on your side, in other side, you are also loving, you are devoted, you are faith, you are so kind. So God will see all these things. It doesn't mean He will forgive you bad things, but He will not only focus on the bad things you did. He will also see your heart. So examine your heart. If God, if you now stand in front of God in the judgment day, what is your heart? What is your heart? A jealous heart, full of hatred, full of anger, or you have a good heart, loving, kind, patient. These are the things that God the Father will see. Yes, He, as human beings, we commit so many mistakes, so many sins. But God is always a loving Father. It's like the relationship of a father and a son. The father will always say to it that the son will always do the right thing. And if the son is not doing the right thing, of course the father will say, don't do that. And the father will always say to him that the son is doing the right thing. And at the end, remember I told you, God sent His only Son not to condemn, but to save. So do not be afraid, like yesterday, Christ is telling Peter, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. When we look at Jesus, Jesus looks at you with a loving heart. He's so loving. He's so loving. He is the, when you say, oh, I am a sinful man, Jesus would not know. Jesus is so loving. And in the worst sinner, Jesus loves everyone. Loves everyone. That's why He's praying to the Father, Father, I don't want to lose anyone you have given me. I will save everyone. Save them, protect them, guide them. That's the prayer of Jesus. That's why our reading today, in the Gospel, Jesus is talking to the Pharisees. That you cannot put the new wine into the old wine skin. What does it mean? It means the new wine, which is brought by Jesus, cannot be mixed with the Old Testament. The Old Testament, yes, is good. But the new wine that Jesus bringing is the new wine. Here you cannot put the new wine into the old wineskin because it will ruin the wineskin and the wine will be destroyed. So the Pharisees will stick to the old one, the fasting. Why? Your disciples are not fasting. The disciples of John, they are doing the fasting. And our disciples are doing the fasting. Why? You are not doing the fasting. And what was the answer of Jesus? When you have the wedding guest, when you have the wedding banquet, and the bridegroom is with you, you will not do fasting. It's a banquet. It's a feast. To be with Jesus is a feast. But there will come a time that you will do a fasting. So, Jesus said, if you are always in the old one, you will say, I don't need a new one. The old is good. But remember, Jesus is bringing you the new wine. The new one, the New Testament, the loving Father. In the Old Testament, we always say, a father is very strict, punishing everyone. But in the New Testament, blessed are the poor in the spirit. Blessed are the kind of heart. Blessed are the merciful. That's the new one. The new one that Jesus brought us. So in the Old Testament, yes, good. But the New Testament is the best Jesus can give us, the new wine. And we cannot mix that with the old wine skin. No, that's the message of Jesus today. And St. Paul is telling us, do not be afraid in the judgment day. God will always see the two parts of you, the bad and the good. That's why we always have time to reflect, to correct. If something to be corrected, then let us do it, and Jesus will help us to do the right thing. with offering the Lord, confirmed as always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy, for you are the one God living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in an approachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all of this so that you may fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your life. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorifying you without ceasing. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him, and with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer and stand in the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who go to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. So immediately after the Mass, we will have the group picture after the Mass. Let us pray. Oh, okay. So after the Mass, we will have also the relics. If you want to kiss the relic of St. Anthony, then you can also ask St. Anthony anything. Healing for your mother, healing for your father, for your families, anything you ask. So let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.